Chapter 6, Lesson 7, Simple Interest, where again we're talking about using multi-step problems to solve things, and down here using our percent problems, where we're looking at that simple interest, our vocab for today, and our skill to be able to calculate simple interest. Let's talk about that. Interest is money paid or money earned for the use of money. So when you get a loan, you have to pay money back. You have to pay interest for using it. However, if you loan money, or rather you give money to the bank in a savings account or other different ways, then you earn, you get free money, which is always great. Principal is the amount of money borrowed or deposited. The key phrase here is it's what you start with. So how much money did you put into the savings account? How much money did you put into that investment account? Or how much did you borrow to start on the loan for that car or that technology or that house, whatever it might be that you're buying and getting the loan for? When we look at these, we're also going to have the word rate, our savings rate, our interest rate, or our APR, something you see a lot with credit cards, is a percent earned or charged. So that's the percent to figure out the interest, but it's going to be the percent, but it has to be used as a decimal. Like we've been using with the percent equation, today it's got to be a decimal. Then we've got time. Obviously, the length that we're going to have the money in the bank, the length of the loan or the investment, but it has to be in years. Cannot stress that enough. You need to bubble cloud or do something around that. This needs to be in years. When we look at all these words, interest, principal, rate, time, IPRT, it's what we're going to use as a formula. I call it my friend or our friend. I call it IPERT or IPART. So friends, everybody say hi. Did you say hi? Wave. That's what we do in class to make you say hi and wave. Simple interest is used by this formula right here. That is an I. Now, normally I would make it with a lowercase I. Some people make it with an uppercase I. I PERT, P-R-T, or I PART. That is what our simple interest formula is. We're going to use it every time. You're welcome to write on in that from those words above that the letter I stands for interest. That's the interest earned or the amount that we're going to pay. Then we've got that letter P, capital P, in a sense. Sometimes we have the principal, the amount of money you start with. Then you have your rate, which is a percent as a decimal. You're welcome to write this in if you want to. It's also just above, in a sense. And then you've got time, which needs to be in years. If it's not in years, we need to fix that. We will make it in years. Now, the other thing they sometimes talk about is they say, find the balance. So the balance meaning is, now that you've got a loan for that car, how much are you going to pay for it in total? Where you're going to take and you're going to have that principal, the amount of money you started with, and then whatever you got over here for your interest, you're going to take that number and add it on in. We'll show that to you. Today, really what I just want to do is I want us to be able to be comfortable with our friend, IPERT, or IPART, comfortable finding simple interest. Let's do that. You put $1,500 into a savings account for 3 years. How much interest do you earn if the savings account has a 5% interest? Money into the bank means when we use our friend, IPERT, there he is again, IPERT, or IPERT, say IPERT. Say IPERT, IPART, whatever one you like in class to make you say, because we're going to write it on in. That's a point, so make sure you show that. Now, we go down the line. Interest, we don't know. The amount of principal, though, we do. We started with $1,500 that we're going to put in and earn free money. Now, here's the thing. Interest, we're not putting 5% in. You must lose the percent sign. Move the decimal to the left. Bump. Bump. Move it twice. So then you got 0.05. And then the time in years is 3. Our friend IPERT,
I part, all the letters are touching. So what's happening between the P, the R, and the T, since they're touching? They're being multiplied. That's all we do. You grab a calculator and you type those in. Be very careful with the calculator and typing them in that you get the right numbers in the right places. You don't miss a zero. You don't put the decimal in the wrong spot, which means when you type it on in, we're going to get $225 free. The bank is just going to give you free money over the course of 3 years, and it's going to add up to a total of $225 in interest. In class, I'd make sure we all got those, so that way we had them right and everything. But here we are. We'll just keep moving on. But before I forget, I must remind you, show me the formula every time. Show me the work, answer, label, and a point for trying. This right here is a 5 stars, 5-point problem on any quiz, test, or graded worksheet assignment for Mr. Walls. Looking again here, you put $200 into a saving account that earns 2% simple interest. What's the interest earned after 5 years, and what's the balance after five? Okay, one question at a time. What's the interest? Interest. Sounds like we need to bring our friend along. IPERT. Everybody say IPERT. Did you say IPERT? Hope you did. In class, I'd be making you say it. So again, IPERT, the P stands for principal, the amount of money we start with, $200. The R is our rate as a decimal. Always remember, you move the decimal twice. If there is no decimal, put it here in the back and go bomp, bomp, times 0.02. Watch the zeros, watch the decimal, and then the time is 5 years. That's my little I. It's almost like a little cursive I, italics I. Just write that on in. Again, type it into the calculator. Double check it. Make sure you've typed in the right amount of zeros, that it's 200 times 2/100ths. That's 0.02 times 5. Give you the number 20. The amount of interest earned, $20. Now it says, what is the balance after 5 years? After 5 years, you go to the bank and you say, I want all my money back. So you start first with the principal. How much money did you earn to start with? You had that $200 plus how much interest did we just earn and figure out over here with our friend IPERT? 20. So the total balance is $220. You will walk away with $220 after 5 years because you got $20 in free money. Again, find the amount of simple interest for 200 at 2.5% for 6 months. Sometimes there's not big word problems. They just say it very, very quickly and briefly. So find the interest. It's our friend, IPERT. Say hi. Hi, friend. Hi, IPERT. Now we go. Find the amount of interest. So we're going to put in our principal. The amount of money we start with, 200. Then times the rate as a decimal. In 2.5%, there's already a decimal. So grab it and move it twice. I've run out of space over there, so I'm going to rewrite it over here so you can see it. Your notes, you have room, but I want you to be able to see it. When you lose the percent sign, that means we're going to move to the left, bomb, bump, two times. So you must be very, very careful that you put in 0. That's why I make this decimal really big, so I can see I need a 0, 2, and a 5. Then times the time, which is in 6 months. Uh-oh. Warning, warning. Time must be in years. Everybody say years. Hope you said years. In class, we'd say it to make sure everyone said it in years. So whenever it doesn't give it to you in years, remind yourself, well, how many months are in a year? 12 months. So since we started with 6, make it a fraction. 6 over 12. Cross your fingers. Hope it makes a nice decimal, and it does. That gives you 0.5. When it doesn't, I can show you a way to make that work, how we can enter it correctly into our calculator so that it will calculate it as a fraction without any rounding or losing decimal places. But this one came out nice. So let's calculate it on out. Again, type it all into your calculator very carefully. If you have to type it in twice to make sure you've typed it in there the right way, make sure you do that, because there's a lot of decimals. There's a lot of zeros. If we miss one, we're going to get the wrong answer. So you type it in and you get $2.50. Quick side note, at the time of this recording, IXL would count this answer wrong, which baffles me. They want you to have a zero there, so it's $2.50. I am not IXL. I will accept $2.50, but we usually are familiar with money having two decimal places, so I welcome you to put the zero at the end. You don't need to. You can. You don't have to. The choice is yours, but if you're doing anything on IXL, make sure that zero is there. Why are we doing this? Well, they're multi-step real-world problems, and again, down here, we need to be able to calculate simple interest. You borrow $3,000 to buy a used car. Pretty good price for a used car. The simple interest rate is 12%. Now, interest rates can change at any time, whether we're talking credit cards, which have high interest rates, which is why you try not to get any credit card debt if at all possible. And auto loans, home loans, they can fluctuate depending on where you go. We even in class sometimes talk about payday loans and all these different things. So right now, we're just going to keep going. It tells you 12%. You pay off the loan in 4 years. How much do you end up paying for your car? Well, not just $3,000. We need to bring our friend along, IPERT, where we need to figure out our interest, because the principal, the amount of money the car cost is $3,000, but then we're going to take this rate, make it a decimal, so times 0.12 times 12 hundredths, and then times it by 4 to figure out just how much interest we are going to pay over the course of this loan. When you type that on in, be very careful that you have enough zeros. I mentioned that in the making of this video, I made a mistake and typed this wrong into my calculator and wrote it wrong. So I just redid it quick and it comes out to be $1,440. Wait, the car costs $3,000, but you only pay this much money? No. What they're asking for up here is they're asking for what's the balance, in a sense. They're asking what's the balance, which means you're going to take the principal, the amount of money it started, plus the interest. So though that car in the car lot said it was a $3,000 car, by the time you're done paying off the loan, that car actually costs you $4,440. It costs more than it did at the car lot. That's what happens when you borrow money. This is true for any car loan, any automobile or toy that you buy, or tech loan. It's even true for a house. The amount of interest you charge on that and pay is outrageous, as in a sense. And we'll talk about that another day, or in class we talk about it too. But moving on, here we go. This is going a little bit further, when we talk about finding an annual interest rate, we're told that we put $700 into account. The account earns $224 simple interest in 8 years. What's the annual interest rate? This one's different. We're going to practice this and have another day two on that. But when we look at this, anytime we're talking about principles and rates and times and simple interest, we're going to use our friend IPERT. Everybody say IPERT. Do you say IPERT? Say IPERT. Now, this one is different because it told us we earned $224 on interest. So plug that guy there. The principal, what do we start with in this one? We start with $700. Then it said to find the rate. So we don't know that. So I'm just going to leave that as R. And then we've got the time. And it said that was 8 years. Good. So now, away we go. When we're looking at this, we'll keep the 224 here on the left side. But what's happening between everything right here, the 700, the R, and the 8, since they're all touching their timesing? So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to just switch my order. I'm going to take 8 times 700 to get 560. R. And now we're going to solve for R. Solve by dividing by 5,600. And once again, as you're typing that into your calculator, be very careful. Take that top number, 224 divided by 5,600. Type that very carefully into your calculator, and you get 0.04 400ths equals R. So what percent is that? Remember, we need to go back to a percent. So go bump, bump. You had a 4% interest rate in that account. Usually what happens here with Mr. Walls' class is I'm going to take a separate day to do this. What I want to do right now is I want to make sure that you are very comfortable here with our friend IPERT, and you can calculate the interest. Always be careful to answer the question. Is it asking for the interest, or is it asking for the balance? And we'll talk about that as we review things and go over this again. But we really want you to be confident using IPERT and plugging things in and multiplying, because when we look at our skill, it is to solve multi-step real-world problems and to apply proportional relationships to solve percent problems involving our simple interest in calculating it, and that's what we're going to do today. Use the simple interest formula. That's our friend, I equals PRT. He's going to be happy to see you. You're going to write him on every problem you do, I equals PRT, so you remember it. Today, we're going to really just figure out to find the interest earned or paid. And we'll come back and we'll do a lot and do some extra practice to find interest rates and all find amount of times. But, you know, we'll also do a little bit of this again today. It's just, what's the balance? How much did you pay total? How much money will you have at the end of the day?